Thank you, Chairman, sir.
Harshvardhan Singh Dungarpur, sir.
Thank you, Chairman, sir. Sir, promulgation of prohibition of electronic cigarettes. Sir, first, I would like to elaborate on the punishment clauses. Any person who contravenes this provision will be punishable with imprisonment up to 1 year or a fine of 1 lakh rupees or both. For any subsequent offences, the person will be punishable with an imprisonment up to 3 years, along with a fine of up to 5 lakh rupees. Additionally, sir, storage of e-cigarettes will be punishable with an imprisonment up to 6 months or a fine of ₹50,000 or both. Once ordinance comes into force, owners of existing stocks of e-cigarettes will have to declare and deposit these stocks at the nearest office of an authorized officer. Now, who is going to be this authorized officer? That's a point to note, because it's very important. So it has been suggested, such as an authorized police officer, or at least at the level of a sub-inspector. So, Chairman, sir, these e-cigarettes are very expensive items. And if they are in the hands of the lower level officers, and each e-cigarette costs 5,000 rupees, so if they are given deposited with the level of a lower officers, this will lead to corruption, I fear, sir. So why is e-cigarette so dangerous? As per report of WHO, electronic nicotine delivery system ends, also known as e-cigarettes, heat a solution to create an aerosol. So that is the dangerous part, which frequently contains flavorants usually dissolved into propylene glycol or glycerin. ENDS aerosol contains nicotine and addictive components of tobacco products. In addition to dependence, nicotine can have adverse effects on development of fetus. Now, this is the most dangerous part. Nicotine can have adverse effects on the development of fetus during pregnancy and may contribute to cardiovascular diseases. The WHO report further states that although nicotine itself is not a carcinogen, it may function as a tumor promoter and seems to be involved in biology of malignant disease, as well as neurodegeneration. Fetal and adolescent nicotine exposure may have long-term consequences for brain development, potentially leading to learning and anxiety disorders. The evidence sufficient to warn children and adolescents, pregnant women and women of reproductive age against ENDS use and nicotine. So another dangerous part, as my colleague Manoj Jha mentioned, that initially, when e-cigarettes were introduced, it was known as a safer alternative.
Yes,
so, which is still a lot of people, even educated people, believe that this is still a very safer alternative, which is the most dangerous part. And so another important thing is that it can also be used, e-cigarettes can be used for delivery of psychoactive substances. So e-cigarettes are available in many different flavors, and this has increase exponentially and has acquired epidemic proportions in developed countries. So especially we have to be very careful in developed countries, and especially among youth and children. And it's very easy to carry in schools. So it has become very fashionable to carry it, especially amongst the younger generation and even as early as school children. And it can easily be carried as a pen or a USB memory stick or any other form. And it's like a cigarette. You light it and there's a smoke and there's a sort of a smell or aroma, but e-cigarette has very little, so it's very easy to use it also. And what is more dangerous, that today's time it has become a fashion statement, sir. So a study conducted in the US have stated that there's a mysterious lung injury in e-cigarette users starting in April, when 50 victims with a median age of 19 years in Illinois and Wisconsin were hospitalized. So now the studies are coming up with the results and how dangerous it is. So e-cigarette makers have been following the time-tested machinations of the big tobacco companies to the T. Like the case of cigarettes, e-cigarettes users also using advertisements depicting e-cigarettes as a glamorous, cool, attractive, liked by celebrities and as a symbol of freedom, together with celebrity endorsements, like the famous ad of Marlboro, come to where the flavor is, come to Marlboro country. Sir, our Prime Minister, the respected Narendra Modi ji, has been very proactive on the ban of e-cigarettes. He has expressed concerns at the United Nations and also in his Mann Ki Baat every Sunday. Sir, he's also warned that e-cigarettes is fast becoming a fashion statement and it should be banned. So lastly, I would like to end by saying I would like to appeal to smokers to really resolve to quit completely rather than being nicotine dependent through unapproved alternatives. Nicotine replacement therapies through nicotine gums, lozenges and patches that are safe and duly approved are available. So with this, Chairman, sir, I support the bill.